gist you what happened to me 2 days ago. Like, anytime I remember it, I'm like, now maybe this. Now maybe this. Is this my life outside? Anyway, 2 days ago, I mean 3 days ago, my kids were on midterm break. So I told my husband that let's go and buy dresses for my kids, because we needed to buy dresses for them, for my brother's wedding, for my brother's white wedding, for Christmas party, you know, even for going out casually, they needed outfits. So I was like, okay, since they're on midterm break, let's just go and get clothes for them. So we went to a store that I go to all the time, okay? I did not even think twice before going to this store, because I go there all the time. They have a lot of dresses, they have a lot of clothes. So I go there all the time to buy clothes for my kids. It's not the one you guys think, because there are two shops that I go to all the time. But one, I always vlog in that shop because they don't have issues with vlogging. But the second shop, the first time we went there, Nelo wanted to buy shoes for her son, so she went to take pictures of the shoe and show her husband. And then they came to meet her and tell her that, you know, they don't allow customers take pictures of the product. Like, and we're like, okay, but on your Instagram page, you will have pictures of the product, so I might as well just go there and collect the picture and send, like, what exactly are you talking about? So because of that incident, even though the manager at some point apologized for it, because of it, I don't really vlog in that shop, but I go there all the time. When I say all the time, I mean I buy everything for my kids there. The last time I took my kids and my husband and we went to that shop, we bought things almost worth 200k. Like, yes, that's how much we shop when we want to shop for them, because we don't shop for them like often, so we shop for them at once most times. So that day we bought shoes it was this year February before their birthday. So we bought shoes, we bought clothes, we bought everything, okay? In between then, I have been going to this shop to buy things, their food, their diapers, toys, clothes. Once in a while, if I want to just buy one item or two, maybe jean shop or something that they need, you know, urgently, I go to that shop and I buy it. It was even me that took the load to that shop for the first time, and the load buys a lot of things too from them. I'm trying to calm myself down because this is just unbelievable. Like, anyway, so this on Friday, we went to the shop. I was with my husband, I was with Sophia. Wanted to buy two dresses for Sophia, one for my brother's birthday, one for my brother's wedding, one for her birthday. Wanted to buy a dress for Ava for my brother's wedding. Wanted to buy a dress for Cora for Christmas party. Wanted to buy casual outfits for them. Wanted to buy shoes, clothes, everything. Like, we were supposed to go there and buy enough. So this time we went to the shop and I realized one thing about Sophia, because we've gone there earlier. Actually, I've gone there earlier to buy dresses for Sophia, but she doesn't like really trying on dresses. Like, she'll start crying and, you know, she'll get cranking. So that day I only bought for Ava, I didn't buy for Sophia. So this time I was like, we're going to do all it takes to make Ava Sophia comfortable, so that we can buy enough dresses for her and me. The thing about me is this, once I like a shop, once I see that the shop has what I need, I really don't like going around looking for options or pricing. I just buy it, so I sit and be going, okay? Because to me, all those pricing, you are spending fuel, you are spending time, you are spending energy to save how much, to gain how much, you know? So that was why I just went straight to that shop. I didn't even think twice. So we came with Sophia's food, came with I was with my phone, so I played Lulu Kids, the cartoon Sophia likes to watch. I played it on my phone for Sophia. Then we brought dresses to try on Sophia. We realized that she cannot wear dresses that for 1 year because she's big. So if you bring any 1 year dress, it's not her size. In fact, the 2 years, like, some of them was difficult to zip. Like, her proper size when it comes to width is like 2 to 3 years, but when it comes to length, you know, 1 year or 18 months or two years is okay when it comes to length, but width is usually 2 to 3 years. So we found one red dress, you know, I tried red dress on her, but in fact to try that red dress was serious for her. Like, we had to play music for her and she cried, but we still put the dress on. So I just told her, man, no need removing this dress, let her just wear it. Since we're buying this dress, let her just wear it, just give her food. When she's now in a good mood, like she's eating, she's full, then we'll remove the dress and then wear her the next one. Anyway, so while I was there, initially someone was attending to me, but when more people came, the person left. In fact, the place was very hot. I had to go and get, I bought a board from somewhere. I was even finding Sophia because I was wearing a dress and, you know, it was hot. So I was finding Sophia. So when nobody was attending to me, I decided to go and look for the dresses myself. My husband was there, he was even looking for shoes for himself. Like, we were planning to buy. Anyway, so I went to look for dresses for Ava. I searched all the racks. Like, I started searching one by one because I was like, I don't want to go anywhere else and look for this dress. Let me just search here. I must find something. Even if it's something I can manage, it's better. So I searched the rack one by one by myself. Nobody was helping me. And I didn't even complain because to me, I was like, yeah, we are plenty here, so I can just help myself. So I went, I now set, I now found a dress that was, that looks okay for Eva. Then I now came to try the dress on Eva. I now called Eva because Eva was playing at one corner. I now called her to come, let me test the dress on her. Next thing, someone walked up to me. I had seen her in the shop walking up and down, so I assumed it's either a manager or something, but I didn't pay attention to her because I was helping myself. Next thing, this lady walked up to me and told me, okay, madam, how many dresses are you buying? Okay, so I was like, I'm buying two for the baby. I've tested one, one is okay. I want to test this other one, but I want her to finish eating before we test the second one, so I should be in a good mood. Then I want to test this one I'm buying now. That's the one I bought for Eva. I want to test this one on Eva, and I'll still search for more clothes. And she was like, okay, so the reason why I'm saying is that so that we can, you know, just like this is what she did to me, so that we can, you know. So initially, you know, me, I don't react immediately, okay? So initially, my brain was like, she shouldn't tell me to hurry up. Is she trying to tell me to do fast and leave her shop? But I said, no, it can't be. So I continued wearing Eva the dress, and she was like, yeah, she's trying to say what she was saying. And I said, wait, I don't understand. What are you trying to say? She now said that, yeah, what she's trying to say is that she's understaffed, and yeah, she needs us to, you know, she did like this again. And I was like, you guys, hey, God. And I was like, I don't understand. What are you saying? What exactly are you saying? Are you saying that I should hurry up? And she was like, yes, yes, try and hurry up because I'm understaffed, and you know, we need to attend to other people. So, and I was like, I don't understand. What are you trying to tell me? That I should hurry up and test a dress that I went to find for myself, for my daughter, because nobody's helping me here. Okay, I have 30 months of that girl. As in, I was so mind blown. I was like, so you're trying to tell me to do fast and leave your shop? She was like, hey, you're misunderstanding me, that she's understaffed, so I should hurry up. I was like, nobody's even attending to me. Like, I said, you're understaffed. Nobody's attending to me. Oh, I didn't even complain for that one. People are attending to one other guy that, you know, came with his son. They're attending to him. I didn't complain. My husband was even looking for shoes by himself. He didn't complain. They're not telling me I should hurry up. Me that I'm attending to myself, I should hurry up because you are understaffed. Hey. And I said, what do you mean? I said, she's giving somebody to come and attend to me and telling me understand. She was like, yeah, yeah, misunderstanding me. That, okay, which one am I taking? Let her know what I'm taking. I was like, see, let me tell something. If not for my husband, what I wanted to do was just drop everything, tell my kids and my, you know, girls, please, can we just be leaving immediately? Like, can we go? Because I'm bringing my money to come and spend in your shop. Like, who are you? Even if you're the only person selling dresses in Port Harcourt, my children will wear their pajamas and go for parties. They will be, in fact, I will go to the market and buy clothes and sew for myself. I mean, I don't have to sew dresses, for crying out loud, which is what I should have thought about doing since. But anyway, I don't really have the time. So I was like, I don't get it. She said, let her help me. And I said, you have to give me somebody. She said, okay, let her help me. But she first called one girl. Okay, this girl should come and help me. But she now said, if you leave that person, now that person, nobody will be attending to that person. Okay, let me attend to her. That's what she now said. So by herself, she was not trying to, she now tried to dress on Eva. In fact, as she was touching my children, I was so irritated. I was like, no, don't worry, it's okay. She was trying to help, because we now removed Sophia's, the red dress Sophia was wearing. She was finished eating at this point. We now removed the red dress Sophia was wearing. I wanted to try another dress, one very fine dress I really liked, you know, went to try it on Sophia. But one thing with these dresses is that their zips are invisible zips, so you need to really calm down, hold the zip together and zip it up. And I was like, I don't have time for that. Even though I like this dress, even though I want to buy this dress, because she has told me to hurry up and leave her shop, let me hurry up too and leave her shop. So, and I knew that dress would be Sophia's size, but I was like, I beg, since it's not even zipping, let's just remove it. Just remove it. My mom was even trying to see if you can zip. I told him, let's just leave it. Let's just leave the dress, okay? Let's just take the one we've already bought and be going. And the reason why I even calm down again was because my kids had already tested the dresses, and they were, especially Eva already excited for the dress. So I was like, me saying I don't want to buy this dress now is going to make them, you know, discouraged. And the fact that we left the house, brought everybody here, hot place, so very hot, like their AC was not even working. We've already brought my kids there. There's no point in me just getting angry and removing these clothes and saying I'm not buying again. Let me just buy it and go. In fact, the man that they were attending to, the man was shocked. Him and his wife, they were like, So people are pushing people from your shop. Then I said, no, we're sorry, ma. While all these things were happening, that woman did not, you know, say any sorry or anything, or any apologies. Like, she was just acting like, you know, I don't know why you're freaking out. Like, I just told you to hurry up. What's there in telling you to hurry up? That kind of behavior. But her staff are begging me, madam, it's okay, I'm so sorry, we're so sorry, please come back. I was telling them, why were even trying to pay? I was telling them that, see, I'm never coming back to this shop again. Like, even if you are the only people selling dresses in Port Harcourt, I will trek to Lagos and go and buy it. If you're the only ones that have the shops in Lagos, I will trek to America and go and buy. If there's no dark clothes in this world, my children will wear pajamas. If you're the only shop in this world, my children will wear their pajamas and go for parties, you know? Anyway, that was it. To see how I'm sweating because of this. Anyway, that was it. That was how I just, You know, we left the shop. In fact, when I even went downstairs, we still added more things. We now ended up buying some of Sophia's snacks and cereal and this and that. On a normal day out, I just walked away. There's no point. Like, if you don't need my money. Because my mom was even laughing at me. He was like, that if you should bring anger meter. God, where my face was. That if you should bring an anger meter to my body, that the meter is going to blow. I was like, I beg. I'm not even finding this thing funny, you know. Him, he was trying to calm the situation. Because even though he agreed with me, even in the car, he was saying it that when the woman was talking, he was like, is this one okay? Like, how can you be telling a customer that you're understaffed? So the customer should hurry up. Like, if there was an issue, if for instance now, let's say we had spent so much time there, maybe they have been bringing dresses for me up on dressing and I did not choose anyone. I was just sitting down there. Maybe if their AC was working, I was just sitting down there with my keys and not doing anything. It's a different case. This one is that I was attending to myself. I was busy searching for dresses. Sophia was trying on one. Eva was sitting at the corner. Everybody was scared. Nobody was complaining. I didn't ask them to give me a staff. I did not tell them anything. I didn't shout on. And there was no queue. It's not like, okay, the shop was full of maybe 100 people that want to come and buy things. We were just three on that floor. You know, they were buying things. They were attending to the man that was with his child already. They had like two or three staff upstairs. Nobody was complaining. Then you now came to me. And maybe she saw me as, I don't know, but it just doesn't make sense. Because if I think about it, the other people that were in the shops, we are men, and she didn't see me with my husband. So maybe she thought like that, you know, now me she get powerful. You get, like, she won't walk up to a man and can't say that kind of nonsense, because I'm sure in her head, the man is the one buying, so he has money. I'm just guessing, because sometimes my fellow women don't have sense when they see men. When they see men, they assume the man has the money and the woman, you know, doesn't have money. So let them give more respect or, you know, reverence to the man and then treat the woman anyhow, okay? Forgetting that in most families, 90% of the spending decisions are made by the women, even though the men are the ones that have the money. If I told my husband I'm not buying any single dress from here, nothing he will do, he will carry his children and go to the next shop. Like, he won't say no, because I've already seen what I like and you don't want it. Me, I want it, so I'll pay for it. He's not going to say that. If I told him I don't want any dress here, let us start going, he will start going. Like, it's what I want that he's going to do at the end of the day, even if he's the one bringing the money. You know, so anyway, all this my rant is just to tell you guys that I was mind blown. Like, even the other customers, they were shocked. I now asked them, when we're paying, and I asked them that woman, is she a manager or, because initially why I didn't even get so angry initially was that I said this person might, I actually thought that I know who the owner is. I thought the owner is one light-skinned woman I've seen in their shop before. So that was why I didn't really blow up, because I just felt like this is a style that does not have sense. Like, you know, when you go and employ a manager, it doesn't have sense. You can't really take business away from the owner simply because the manager does not have sense, you know. So that's what I thought initially. But when we were paid, I just said, let me even ask that lady, who is she? Is she a manager or whatever? They now told me that she's the owner. That one pained me. Remember that her, she's the owner. The thing pained me. I was like, chai! I would have walked away, because if I had known she was the owner when she did that thing, I would have finished her. Like, I would have had so many things to say to her at that point, because I would have said, you don't even have sense. Like, you don't even have sense. Like, it's not to look for customer, because all the shops I go to, especially when I now come with my kids, it's even worse. If I go alone, people might not really attend to me so much. But if I go with my kids, they'll tell you, madam, don't worry, sit down. Do you want this? Do you want that? Because you know, when you're with children, you are more likely going to buy what you wouldn't even buy on your own. Because when your child points to something and your child really likes something, or when you test something on your child and it looks beautiful on your child there and there, you are more likely going to buy that thing because your child has tested it and it's your child's size, okay? So most shops that I go to, if I go with my kids, if I go with Sophia and, you know, Cora and Eva, and I go there and sit down, everybody will not be bringing out more. Don't you want this one? Try this one. Baby girl, don't you like this? And I say, don't be showing my children, show me, so that they won't can't choose, you know. That's what I experience in most shops that I go to. I don't even go with my husband most times, you know. And when I don't go with my husband, I still get treated well, I still get treated nicely. But this one, like, I even feel like part of the reason why she even calmed down was when she now saw my husband. I don't know, because when she came to meet me, my husband was not there. He was busy searching for dresses, for shoes somewhere else. I feel like it's when he came out to understand what was going on, she now realized that, this woman is with this man. So she now changed her tone and started saying, she was even telling Eva, this dress is really fine for you. Why is your mother fighting me for this dress? And I was just like, who is fighting you? I know the one that came here with your senseless talk. Like, how am I even fighting you? If you see fights, will you be able to talk? Anyway, finish ranting. But shop owners need to do better in this Nigeria. Shop owners, Instagram vendors from left, right, and center, people need to do better. People need to go and learn customer service. It's not enough for you to open up a shop with millions of naira and you don't know basic customer service. It's not enough. Don't think that because your shop is popping today, it's going to pop forever. Like, you can never be bigger than your customer because you don't know who is who. You don't know how much I was prepared to spend in that shop. Now, because of how the woman treated me, I was forced to go and look for other alternatives, okay? That laziness has left my body. She has insulted the laziness out of me. So today, I was forced to go and look for other shops. I took my kids to go and buy clothes, and we bought a bunch of things. Like, these are clothes for my kids, shoes, bags. Okay, no bags, but shoes, dresses. I have to buy from a different shop this time, you know. I went to two different shops actually. I even saw what I wanted. I even saw them at affordable rates, and I was just like, look at the green dress that I was looking for in that shop for Cora. That's that shop where they insulted me. I was looking for a green dress, they didn't have, but now I have seen a green dress, okay? This other ones was red dresses I needed for my brother's wedding, because all of us are wearing something a little bit like this. Look at the red wine colored dresses. So what is it? Look at it, it's very beautiful dress itself. I even saw more options than I had in their shop. Yeah, so this one is 2 years. So this is what Sophia will wear. Lengthwise is a bit long, but it's not like she's walking. So anyway, this one is for Ava. Then this one is for Cora. I know how much these three dresses cost already. These three dresses are already almost 50k. Yeah, I got this one for Sophia's birthday. It's just the onesie. Sophia's birthday is in December. I'm already preparing. It's just a onesie and tutu skirt. And then I got white shirts for my kids. Then I got shoes for Sophia. You guys, can you believe this Sophia's shoe? Like, look at how long this shoe is. That girl is big, oh. This is size 23. Sophia is wearing size 23. This is size 4. Ah! Sophia is big, oh. Anyway, that's just the rant I came to rant for you guys. And I do this thing a lot. Once I just like one particular shop, I start going there. Even when I know that this shop is more expensive, even when I know that they don't really have what I want, they don't really have many options, but because I'm used to them, I just keep going back. Not anymore, because insults, it's not, I don't like insults. Anyway, that's it for this rant. Let me go and get food ready for my husband. Today is Monday, still midterm break for my kids. They're upstairs now making noise. I just even came back now and just started ranting, but let me just go and show my husband this outfit so that I can collect my money back, okay?